गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 and 2 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 2.2 एंड 3rd and 4th वाज होमवर्क. नाउ वी आर मूविंग टू अ क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज टू नंबर्स आर इन अ रेशियो ऑफ 5:3. सो दे आर द टू नंबर्स एंड दीज आर इन फॉर्म ऑफ 5:3. That means is first of all there were two number. If you divide that number, if you divide both the number by the same number, suppose these are the two number. You divide both the number by the same number. Suppose you divide by x. We didn't know what was the number which you use as a division. If you divide both the number by the x, you will get 5 and 3. First of all, there were the two number. You divide both the number by the same number. Then you get a 5:3. Second line is given if they differ by 18. Now the second line is given differ means a difference. The difference between both the number. These are the two number. The difference between both the numbers. That means you subtract a smaller from a greater one. You will get a 18. So now you have to find out what are the numbers. What the numbers? So ratio means you have to divide by the same number. So suppose we divide them by x. So again we will multiply. So first of all, the given is ratio of two numbers is given 5:3. How we get a 5:3? If we divide a number by the same number, then we get a 5:3. Now we will do just opposite. Now again we will multiply both the number with the same. Let imagine the numbers are 5x and 3x. Okay, you divide them by x, then you get a 5:3. Then next again we will multiply by 5x and then 3x. So now these are the number. And if you talk about the second statement, this one is given in a question. It is given that if they differ by 18, that means a difference between both the number. A difference between both the number is 18. And what are the numbers? Number is 5x and 3x. That means if we subtract 3x from a 5x, these are the two numbers. 3x is a smaller one and 5x is a greater one. So if we subtract or if we find the difference, we will get 18. So 5x minus 3x is equal to 18. So now 5x minus 3x is equal to 2x. Now it is given 2x equal to 18. So what is your value of x? Here is a multiplication of 2 and x. So if we remove the 2 from left hand side, in right hand side it will be used as a divisor. So 18 divided by 2. So x equal to 9. That means the number you divide, the number is 9. You use a 9 as a divisor. If the value of x is a 9, then the numbers are, then numbers are, first number is 5x, that means 5 into 9, that means you can get a 45. And second number 3 multiplied with x, that means 3 into 9, you will get a 27. So the numbers are 45 and 27. If you want to check, you can, like there are two statements are given, 45 and 27. If we divide 45 and 27 by 9, so 9 5 is 45 and 9 3 is 27, you are getting a ratio of 5:3. If we talk about the statement that they differ by the 18, that means the difference is 18, you can check the difference is 18 or not. So 45 minus 27 45, that you cannot subtract, so take a borrow, it will become 3 and it will become now 15 minus 7 8, and 3 minus 2 you will get a 1. That means you are getting the same one that was even in your statement. If you divide by the 9, you will get a 5 ratio 3, and if you find the difference, you are getting a 18. So your answer is 45 and 27. So that is the solution of question number 5. So the question number 6 you have to solve as a homework. Now moving to our question number 7. A sum of 3 consecutive multiples of 8 is a 888. Talk about the multiples. For example, the multiple of 8 are 8, 16, 24. These are the consecutive multiple. Suppose the first multiple is x. Now if we need a second multiple, that means we have to add 8 in the second number. In first number, if we add a 8, we will get a 16. First multiple is 8, the second multiple is 16. If we need a second number, that means we have to add a 8, because these are the multiple of 8. Now if we talk about the third multiple, that means we have to add 16 in the first number, or even you can say that you can add a 8 in the second number. 8 is already added, you have to add 8 more. So the multiple will be, first multiple will be x, a second multiple you have to add 8, and third multiple you have to add 16. So these are the three multiple, a consecutive multiple of 8. So the numbers are x, x plus 8, and x plus 16. Okay. So now if we talk about the statement, this one is given in your book. Let me, according to the question, it is given that the sum of a 3 consecutive multiple is 888. That means these are the 3 consecutive multiple, x, x plus 8, and x plus 16. These are the 3 multiple. If you add all 3, you have to get 888. So x, x and x, you will get a 3x. And if we talk about the numbers 8 and 16, you will get a 24 equal to 888. First of all, you have to shift 24 from left hand side to right hand side. So here will be on the 3x, and here 888 minus 24. First of all, we have to subtract. So 3x equal to 8 minus 4, 4. 8 minus 2, 6, and 8 minus nothing. So that means 864. Now if you need a value of x, you have to remove the 3 from left hand side to right hand side, or even you can say that cross multiply. 864 divided by 3. So value of the x will be 8 to the 6, so remainder will be 2 divided by 3. 8 to the 6, remainder 2, next number 6, 24. So 3 8 is 24, remainder 2, next number is 4, again 3 8 is 24. So here you are getting 288. That means the value of n, that means the first number is, or the first multiple of 8 is a 288. So if we talk about all three multiple, so x equal to 288, the second number is x plus 8, that means 288 plus 8, so you will get 296, and next multiple is x plus 16, so 288 plus 16, that means you will get, you 8 and 6 4, you will get a 304. So your answer is 288, 296 and 304. These are the three consecutive multiple of 8, where you can add all three numbers, you will get 888. Okay. Yes, so that's it for today. Question number 6, you have to solve as a homework. Don't forget. And if you have any problem, you can ask. Thank you.